Advancements in technology have often been a landmark representing a new era for humanity. The Industrial Revolution marked the beginning of our society moving from a rural to urban society. And the Digital Revolution has marked unparalleled connectivity with the most technological advancements being made using AI. However, just as the Industrial Revolution caused many unexpected challenges, we are beginning to see the environmental impacts of AI on our climate. I will be the first to admit, I very quickly jumped on the AI train. One of my most notable AI uses was when I participated in a competition where I had to train and race AI car models. My team spent hours training and optimizing, and it paid off as our model was placed in the top 10% of all cars raced in the Americas. Despite this, I still had this nagging feeling. I had previously heard about the emissions associated with AI, and I was curious, so I did some digging, and I found an equation to calculate the emissions that my model had generated. In just 14 hours, my team produced 0.687 pounds of carbon. For reference, the average commercial flight emits 53.3 pounds of carbon per mile. This means that my model produced 1.3% of a plane's carbon emissions. Now, this statistic may not sound that staggering initially, but I would like to remind you all that we are comparing a desktop to an actual plane. Technology has always been at the forefront of controversy. From ethics to jobs, academics to apps, to even camera quality or the number of camera lenses, changes and evolutions in technology have sparked so many debates, yet we rarely see the emissions headlining. Artificial intelligence and machine learning have revolutionized industries, augmenting human capabilities and changing nearly every single part of our lives. However, the continuous expansion of AI technologies is accompanied by a growing concern: the environmental impacts and costs of carbon emissions. Today, we will talk about the intricate relationship between AI processes and their significant contributions to carbon and greenhouse gas emissions. First, we'll be talking about AI's mechanisms and carbon output. AI's functionality hinges on mechanisms such as machine learning, deep learning, natural language processing, and computer vision. Machine learning detects patterns in data using algorithms, while deep learning uses a neural network for tasks like image recognition and speech synthesis. Natural language processing actually allows AI to understand human language, and computer vision aids in the interpretation of visual data. However, the cost of these mechanisms is their substantial emissions stemming from their energy-intensive nature and consequential carbon footprint. Next, we'll be talking about emissions across AI. According to Annette Atkins, one of the foremost contributors to carbon emissions in AI processes is the training of deep learning models. This entails the intricate process of iterative data processing and optimization, which is often facilitated by graphical processing units or tensor processing units, which I will refer to as GPUs and TPUs, respectively. The energy consumption during this stage is particularly high when using high-performance hardware, resulting in a notable carbon footprint. According to Renee Cho and her paper, AI's growing carbon footprint, data collection and annotation, a vital component for training AI models, amplifies emissions when relying on non-renewable energy sources. Additionally, mentioned by Atkins, real-time inference, a core functionality of many AI applications, maintains an extremely high and continuous energy consumption pattern. The extent of emissions varies based on the energy sources power lying the underlying servers. Tasks like NLP and computer vision exhibit high computational demands when relying on carbon emissions to produce the training of the models. This happens during both training and inference. Moreover, the intricacies of generative models, like generative adversarial networks, or GANs for short, escalate emissions due to the energy-intensive adversarial training. Next, we'll be talking about addressing the emission challenge. According to Cho, mitigating the environmental impact of AI and AI processes requires a multifaceted approach. One critical aspect involves opting for energy-efficient hardware to minimize energy consumption throughout AI's developmental phases. This entails the careful selection of hardware components such as GPUs and TPUs that strike a balance between performance and the energy efficiency. The idea was further expanded in an MIT technology review by Karen Howe titled AI's Carbon Footprint is Bigger Than You Think. In this paper, she shares that equally significant is the adoption of sustainable practices for data collection and utilization. Utilizing renewable energy sources such as solar and wind power to fuel infrastructure that supports AI processes substantially reduces the carbon footprint. Moreover, deliberate efforts to streamline hyperparameter tuning and training methods contribute to notable energy savings. Simply, the emissions drawn from AI stem from where they are actually getting the power to create the models. So, the key to cleaning up AI emissions is to actually clean up where they are getting that power from. Next, we'll be talking about quantifying the carbon emissions. At this point, you may not understand just how big of an issue this is, which is why it is so important that we quantify the carbon emissions. Quantifying carbon emissions associated with AI processes is a vital and critical step for informed decision making. Recent research projects have utilized the concept of carbon equivalence to provide a standardized metric for assessing emissions. By utilizing carbon emissions, we gain a comprehensive understanding of the global warming potential of various greenhouse gases relative to carbon dioxide. These quantification efforts shed light on the magnitude of the emissions associated with AI operations. For instance, as Cho had mentioned, the training of a massive AI model, such as GPT-3, consisting of 175 billion parameters, let me say that again, 175 billion parameters, resulted in a staggering 502 metric tons of carbon emissions. This carbon output is equivalent of driving 112 gasoline-powered cars nonstop for an entire year. Not only this, but Howe further points out in her paper that the carbon output of training a single big language model is equal to roughly 300,000 kilograms of carbon emissions. Now, this is equivalent of taking 125 round-trip flights from New York to Beijing. Next, we'll talk about data centers and their carbon impact. Now that we understand just how much of an impact AI is making on our climate, it is important that we address the key changes that we actually can make. The roles of data centers in AI is undeniable, and their energy consumption contributes significantly to the carbon emissions associated with AI. The energy-intensive nature of data centers, driven by the need to power servers and provide cooling, requires a multifaceted and comprehensive assessment of their environmental impact. Data centers predominantly rely on fossil fuels, contributing to about 2.5 to 3.7% of all global greenhouse gas emissions. As stated in Jude Coleman's, AI's climate impact goes beyond its emissions. Moving towards a sustainable data center will significantly reduce the carbon emissions associated with AI. the uneven distribution of renewable resources and regulatory challenges absolutely presents hurdles, but the long-term benefits of reduced carbon impact justifies that initial investment. Additionally, the selection of data center location plays a pivotal role in minimizing direct carbon emissions. The proximity to renewable resources and efficient cooling solutions, as well as adherence to environmental regulation, should be what we're focusing on when informing these decisions. Another key aspect, or incredibly important part of AI, is the hardware selection. Efficient hardware selection significantly impacts AI's carbon footprint. Comparing performance and energy efficiency through metrics like flops per watt allows us to gain a comprehensive understanding, as well as highlighting the advantages of certain hardware configurations. According to Nicholas Sundberg, specifically for AI processes, GPUs outperform CPUs in terms of energy efficiency, and TPUs, which were actually developed by Google and specialize in AI computation, exhibit even further gains, being up to 8 times more efficient than GPUs. Context-based specifications and considerations, such as low-power GPUs for embedded application, ensure the balance and optimization between performance and energy efficiency. Overall, it may be said that the exponential growth of AI technologies brings forth unparalleled advancements. However, this progress should be matched and balanced with our environmental responsibilities. By addressing the carbon emissions and environmental impact of AI processes from training to deployment, we can move towards a more sustainable era. By leveraging energy-efficient hardware, adopting sustainable solutions, and investing in innovative solutions, AI can continue to reshape industries while minimizing its carbon footprint. As the pursuit of technological advancements meets with environmental mindfulness, the future of AI can absolutely hold the promise of coexisting with our planet. And while we are all too concerned about what the future of AI holds for us, let us not let the future of our planet escape us. So, what does our climate mean to you? Thank you.